the next paper jumps away from biochemistry and moves into theory of mind. And the paper is presented by Ms. Anke Maria Sav, who is a PhD student in psychology at the University of Paris 8 in France. Welcome.
Hello, Kalimera. I will present you today two studies in autism syndrome, in Asperger syndrome, and in high functioning autism. Actually, we didn't distinguish between the two populations in our studies. So the first one will be on an advanced test of theory of mind, and the other one on reward association learning. So the Asperger syndrome is a specific pervasive developmental disorder within the autism spectrum disorder, and within the clinical features we remember troubles in forming friendship, difficulties with social cognition, diminished capacity for empathy, and poor nonverbal communication. There is no intellectual retardation or language delay in Asperger syndrome. Two of the main deficits in autism are on dysfunction in theory of mind and on executive dysfunction. So the first theory of mind dysfunction theory, is based on impairments found in understanding others in terms of desire, intention, and beliefs. And the second theory is based on the impairments found in tasks like Tower of Hanoi, which is a planning task, or in flexibility task and set shifting ability. So the theory of mind, known also like mind reading or mentalizing, represents the ability to understand other people's minds, to deceive their intention, emotion, and thoughts. Individuals with Asperger syndrome or high functioning autism succeed on the first order and second order test of theory of mind, but they have difficulties in more advanced theory of mind tasks like strange stories or faux pas test of Baron Cohen. So our first study presented today is a new advanced theory of mind test presented like a multiple choice test. With four available, we presented some social stories, neutral social stories, because there is no important conflict in the stories. And to explain the behavior of one of the characters, the participants had to choose between four available propositions: good intention, explanation, bad intention, false belief, or habits. They also had to report their confidence degree, and we also measured the fact if they switch or not their perspective on a social situation when they have another different opinion. So the aims of this study was to evaluate mentalizing abilities of Asperger population, and to test also the mental flexibility involvement in social reasoning in Asperger population. So this is an example of a story. Louise goes to the butcher to buy some meat. There are a few persons waiting to be served. She asks the butcher, "May I have a farm chicken, please?" He nods and starts to pack a roast chicken. "Sorry," she says, I've asked you if I might have a farm chicken." "Oh, I'm sorry," says the butcher, "there is no farm chicken left." And the question, why did the butcher start to pack a roast chicken for her instead of a farm chicken? Each participant had four available answer. They had to choose a single one, and then they had to choose their confidence level in their answer on a scale from 1 to 5, from not sure at all to very sure. And in the second phase of the test, the same story was presented with the same question, but this time the participant had to choose between their first answer and the opinion of another person. They also had to report their confidence level in this new answer. Our participants were Asperger group was recruited in Albert Chenevier Hospital in France. The two groups were have the same age, education level, and IQ level, and the results, actually, the patterns of response are very, very similar. The same, there are the same pattern in the two groups, and we are asking if there is a facilitator effect of executive function low demand on theory of mind performance. So the second part of the presentation is on the executive functions, which is the ability to maintain an appropriate problem-solving set for attainment on a future goal. It comprises the cognitive process which control and manage thinking and action, and they are driven by the prefrontal cortex. In Asperger population, there are differences in their performance within executive function. So we find difficulties for the cognitive flexibility, but not in the inhibition. So the aims on our second study were to verify inhibition capacities in Asperger individuals over a cognitive control test, and also to study different links between executive function and theory of mind capacities. So two other groups of participants with there were all adults, so our studies are on an adult population with the same education level and IQ level. And the test that we utilized was a cognitive flexibility one with a stimulus reinforcement learning. So the test had two parts, a reversal and an extinction. In every part, there were two patterns. The participant had to choose the pattern who will allow him to gain points. So he had to find a good pattern, but when the subject reaches the rules, when he find the pattern, the good one, the rule changes. So the relationship between the patterns and the consequences reverses without warning. In the extinction patterns, after once the subject reaches the rule, it was not correct to touch either of the patterns anymore. Our results, actually, we find a difference only in the first block, for the first block of patterns, but not in the others one. So once the criterion was achieved, Asperger individuals were able to show no severe impairment in reversal and extinction learning. We found a correlation between establishing stimulus reward association in difficulties with the low scores in social reciprocal interaction. Actually, we found a correlation between it in the score of FOPA test, which is an advanced theory of mind test, with the correct response in number in reversal test, which is our executive test. And we also, this is the result to make the links between the two studies, we found an association, a correlation between correct answers in the reversal with the global proportion of answer changing in our test. So, our conclusion might be that there is a reward learning transfer in social life, at least in performance on social tests. Our results are also in the same direction with other development evidence of executive function role in theory of mind development. And as a practitioner, I could say that we already utilize this principle of reward learning in working methods like ABI, applied behavioral analysis. So,
thank you. Any questions from the floor?